Forgiveness. From Adam, we were genetically infected by sin, with our need to recognize and overcome sin, and the various symptoms of sin is the need to recognize the good and perfect gift of forgiveness. Through the Lord Jesus, we have the right to give and accept forgiveness. By God's word, we see sin's character. By truth, which represents the character of the Lord Jesus, we see our need. To recognize our continued need for forgiveness is a good and perfect gift, which we are able to gain from the Word of God. The gospel of the Lord Jesus reveals sin and its remedy. Galatians 3:24-27. Wherefore the law was our schoolmaster to bring us unto Christ, that we might be justified by faith. Matthew 1:21. And she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins. Acts 5:31. Him hath God exalted with his right hand to be a prince and a savior, for to give repentance to Israel and forgiveness of sins. We have repeated need for forgiveness. Forgiveness comes from the Lord. We are called upon to recognize we need to forgive and to accept forgiveness. We will always need to recognize our falling short. We will always need to accept God's good and perfect gift of forgiveness. To overcome our recurring transgressions and shortcomings, we need forgiveness. The Lord has provided us with many good and perfect counsels, which includes being like our God. By forgiving those who offend us, we will be demonstrating likeness to our Lord God. Psalm 86:5. For thou, Lord, art good and ready to forgive, and plenteous in mercy unto all them that call upon thee. Forgiveness is about our Lord God, the Holy Spirit, along with the Heavenly Father and the Lord Jesus, fills the needed role in bringing us to forgive and offer forgiveness. The Lord, by His goodness, leads us to admit and grieve for sin. The Lord leads us to confession and repentance of sin for forgiveness. Having knowledge of why Jesus had to shed His blood for us, and the reason no other person would do, is important for us. According to God's Word, Jesus is God's only accepted sin sacrifice. There could be no forgiveness of sins if there were no shedding of Jesus' blood. Romans 2:4. Despisest thou the riches of His goodness and forbearance and longsuffering, not knowing that the goodness of God leadeth thee to repentance? 1 John 1:9. If we confess our sins, He is faithful and just to forgive us our sins and to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Ephesians 1:7. In whom we have redemption through His blood, the forgiveness of sins, according to the riches of His grace. Genesis 22:8. And Abraham said, My son, God will provide Himself a lamb for a burnt offering. So they went both of them together. John 1:29. The next day, John seeth Jesus coming unto him, and saith, Behold the Lamb of God, which taketh away the sin of the world. Colossians 1:14. To whom we have redemption through His blood, even the forgiveness of sins. The gift of forgiveness is sandwiched between our hearing the counsels of the Lord and humbly turning away from the practice of sin. Forgiveness also includes our treatment of one another to respond to others' wrongs against us in the same way the Lord God repeatedly forgives our sins. Jeremiah 31:34. And they shall teach no more every man his neighbor and every man his brother, saying, Know the Lord, for they shall all know me, from the least of them unto the greatest of them, saith the Lord. For I will forgive their iniquity, and I will remember their sin no more. Our Lord warns us in love concerning continuing in sinful ways, identified with forgetting the Lord God. By warnings of sinful ways, we are encouraged to hear the word of God. When we hear and turn from sin, the Lord is good and ready to forgive. Jeremiah 36:3. It may be that the house of Judah will hear all the evil which I purpose to do unto them, that they may return every man from his evil way, that I may forgive their iniquity and their sin. Psalm 86:5. For thou, Lord, art good and ready to forgive and plenteous in mercy unto all them that call upon thee. In the Old Testament, our experiences involving forgiveness, as we consider that which it takes to ask for forgiveness and to give forgiveness, we profit. Forgiving blesses those forgiving and those who receive forgiveness. Genesis 50:15-21. And when Joseph's brothers saw that their father was dead, they said, Joseph will peradventure hate us and will certainly requite us all the evil which we did unto him. And they sent messenger unto Joseph, saying, Thy father did command before he died, saying, So shall ye say unto Joseph, Forgive, I pray thee now, the trespass of thy brethren and thy sin, for they did unto thee evil. And now we pray thee, forgive the trespass of the servants of the God of thy father. And Joseph wept when they spake unto him, and his brethren also went and fell down before his face. And they said, Behold, we be thy servants. And Joseph said unto them, Fear not, for am I in the place of God? But as for you, ye thought evil against me, but God meant it unto good, to bring to pass, as it is this day, to save much people alive. Now therefore, fear ye not, I will nourish you and your little ones. And he comforted them and spake kindly unto them. Joseph, acknowledging the Lord, gave him a tender, forgiving heart, knowing that the Lord forgives, tells us to forgive. The Lord God blessed Joseph in the time of his distress. Joseph trusted that even in hard situations, God leads. Joseph was able to forgive his brothers by seeing the Lord God in his sorrows. The Lord gave Joseph purpose for being able to forgive his brothers with kindness. Abigail trusted in God's promises to bring blessings following her husband's Nabal's abrupt actions of insulting David and his men. Abigail, reflecting on God, approached David with a reminder of God's plan for David. Abigail humbled herself, kneeling before David by her words. Abigail also kneeled to the Lord God in her heart and in her spirit. Abigail took responsibility for the wrong of her husband. With submission, Abigail asked for forgiveness. 1 Samuel 25:23-28. and 31. And when Abigail saw David, she hasted and lighted off the ass and fell before David on her face and bowed herself to the ground and fell at his feet and said, "Upon me, my Lord, upon me let this iniquity be, and let thine handmaid, I pray thee, speak in thine audience, and hear the words of thine handmaid. Let not, my Lord, I pray thee, regard this man of Belial, even Nabal, for as his name is, so is he. Nabal is his name, and folly is with him. But I, thine handmaid, saw not the young men of my Lord, whom thou didst send. Now therefore, my Lord, as the Lord liveth, and as thy soul liveth, seeing the Lord hath withholden thee from coming to shed blood, and from avenging thyself with thine own hand, now let thine enemies and they that seek evil of my Lord be as Nabal. And now this blessing which thine handmaid hath brought unto my Lord, let it even be given unto the young men that follow my Lord. I pray thee, forgive the trespass of thine handmaid, for the Lord will certainly make my Lord a sure house, because my Lord fighteth the battles of the Lord, and evil hath not been found in thee all thy days. But when the Lord shall have dealt well with my Lord, then remember thine handmaid." Abigail made an appeal for David to remember her at the time when the Lord God's promises were realized. Abigail's manner of approaching David was God's mercy. Abigail's appeal itself was an encouragement for David to trust the Lord at a time when forgiveness was needed. Yielding to Jesus allows us to forgive and receive forgiveness. As our actions become of the Lord Jesus, we are blessed by the actions we take to forgive. Forgiveness is an obedient act, identifying the heart, mind, and spirit of the Lord. We are blessed as we take on the identity of being forgiven forgivers. Ephesians 4:32, "And be ye kind one to another, tender-hearted, forgiving one another, even as God, for Christ's sake, hath forgiven you." As we acknowledge our Lord, we focus on his example. As Jesus paid in blood for our sins on the cross, Jesus humbly forgave. We have encouragement by Jesus' matchless example. Jesus is the Spirit of love. Humbly accepted. Jesus, in the Spirit of love, humbly accepted the cruel cross for us. Our Lord leads us to forgive. There is no greater demonstration of love than that of the Lord Jesus' willingness to forgive, spat upon, verbally and physically abused, in agony. Jesus forgave, suffering inhumane Roman-style punishment. Jesus, in distorted appearance and extreme pain, forgave. Isaiah 52:14. "As many were astonished at thee, his visage was so marred more than any man, and his form more than the sons of men." Luke 23:34. "Then said Jesus, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. And they parted his raiment and cast lots." Acts 5:31. "Him hath God exalted with his right hand to be a prince and a savior, for to give repentance to Israel and forgiveness of sins." Acts 13:38. "Be it known unto you therefore, men and brethren, that through this man is preached unto you the forgiveness of sins."